shed.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Bill Kirkup from Scurus, and it's a distinct pleasure for me tonight to welcome an individual from my area that I grew up in, and I think nobody better can speak about it than he can, and that's where we'll wrap it. Before I start, I want to back up a bit and congratulate all of those tonight that have stood up here and fall. It's an honor. It's Old Home Week, and it's a pleasure to be part of it. I talked about Orwell, that having grown up in this area myself, I'm very familiar with his stomping grounds. This corner of the province has been home to a number of teams for as long as I can remember, covering some 60 square miles along the USA and Saskatchewan border. We are not sure of the date of inception for the Southwest Baseball League, but it appears to have been after World War II, when 4 to 6 teams were involved. Like any other league, the Southwest Baseball League struggled at times to stay viable. The league was temporarily shut down in 2012 and reactivated 2 years later, due in large part to Orwell's dedication, commitment, and communication to all the teams in the region. A big feat, however. The reinstatement of previous member teams, plus 2 teams from the defunct MSBL, the Southwest Baseball League now operates in 2 divisions consisting of 11 teams. I would refer you to the Orwell Bio program, and there's one thing that could be added. You notice the bio covers its baseball activity centered around the Southwest Baseball League. So I suggest if you look at the program, in turn you might use the slogan, "I've been everywhere, man." And he has. You'll notice in there it states, of course, that Orwell did, you know, all his presidency and all that. But he had his own time to occupy for years and years and years. There's a little story. I'm an old umpire. I've taken the umpire too, so I'm going to get a verbal one right now. In reference to his umpire duties, Orwell was noted for being an umpire who consistently gave double pitch. Very popular with the pitchers, not all the hitters. From this I've gathered a little story, which may be fabricated, but nonetheless I'm going to tell it to you. It pertained to a call third strike in a crucial game where he called a batter out on a low pitch, about ankle high. And the batter reported, "Mr. Umpire, that pitch was right in my ankles." To which Orwell replied, "Could very well be, but it's still strike 3. And with that, for induction to the Builders Academy of the Hall, please welcome Mr. Orwell Frederick as a new inductee.
Thank you, Bill. They asked me in the interview, I said, wondered if I was a Red Sox fan, and I said, no, not what they were thinking. It's colder on the back of this hat. Anyhow, I told them I was a Blue Jay fan, so there we go. Anyhow, congratulations to all the inductees, the glory men, and the ones still to come. It's a great pleasure to be here. I'd like to thank the nominees that made this possible, and I'd like to say thank you to my family for all here tonight. I just have a couple of stories. Everybody's been talking about baseball, and this is kind of baseball, but I think it says in the book that we, in 68, I think we were fortunate enough to have a decent team down in the southwest corner. Oh yeah, I get a home run in Saskatchewan one night too. Anyhow, we played Thompson in the finals back in 68, provincial, whatever level it was, seniors. than just the way things have gone in the last few years, and it was one way to remember that, but we got up to Thompson, which is a new city, and we had a clay diamond, and it rained, and it rained. Anyhow, we get up the next morning, and how are we going to play? Well, the fuel company come over with, I think, I don't know, it was 1,500 or 15,000 gallons of gasoline, dumped it on the ball diamond, threw a match out. 15 or 20 minutes later, it came a helicopter and hovered for a while. You know what? Field was just fine. Yeah. So, you know, sometimes we don't see what was on behind the scene of people just as well, but I'd like to know what would happen today. The other thing, when I got called into Brandon last fall, they were announcing inductees, and I said I got a bit jump. Quite a bit of bump wiring, and I think I remember that low pitch, but he could have hit it. Yeah. Anyhow, we were sitting there waiting for them to now deduct these, and there's only one umpire inducted in the Hall of Fame per year, and they announced him first. And it wasn't my name. Ross Tyke was sitting beside me, and he said, I guess we might as well go home and look like you're going to make it. So somebody must have held territory. Anyhow, I didn't bring up any notes because I can't read.